Hello everyone. First of all, Assalamu alaikum everyone. My name is Istiaq Muhammad Tanbeer Islam Sahib. My metric ID is ET191077. ID number is 191077. Today I'm gonna brief a presentation based on our lab report. The circuit, the subject I choose to as a presentation is called clamped circuit. First of all, what is a clamped circuit? The clamped circuit moves the circuit that moves the signal ups and downs to set either the positive peak or the negative peak of the signal as a desired level. To fulfill the clamped circuit, the equipment that we need to fulfill the clamped circuit, first of all, a breadboard, second of all, a capacitor, resistor, signal generator, DC power supply, oscilloscope, and diode. In the lab report, we see that we use a negative clamped circuit. And we are, the supply voltage will be 10 volt peak to peak, and 500 hertz will be hertz. I also describe the equipment that is used in the clamped circuit. First of all, capacitor. Capacitor used to use for to block DC supply and block DC supply and only pass AC supply. Here, let me indicate. Here, the negative wire, the small wire indicates negative, and the long wire indicates positive. Diode is used to pass only one one direction, for only one direction. The other direction will be just like, and the current is forward, going forward, the reverse current is blocked. An ideal diode will have zero resistance. Infinite, and I also include infinite resistance is in the reverse direction. Infinite resistance is the reverse direction of it. Resistor used to reduce the current flow is only used to block current, reduce current flow. It also, resistor was a converting electric energy to heat. It also use resistor. DC power supply, it is used to supply constant supply. In here, in the lab report, we can see we need 10 volt peak to peak, and the DC power supply X will supply 10 volt, not less than 10, or exactly 10 volt. The supply will be 10 volt. Oscilloscope, it is used to see the waveform. In the breadboard, we use capacitor, resistor, diode in the breadboard. And when we add channel 1 and channel 2, we see in the waveform just like that, the 10 volt peak to peak and 500 hertz waveform. Signal generator used to supply the signal. In here, we see the 500 hertz. The signal generator will supply 500 hertz in the breadboard, and when we add channel oscilloscope in the breadboard, that we see, we can see signal just like that. But let's take the first of all in input, the breadboard input, let me take it. We see capacitor and resistor and diode are connected with parallel with the capacitor. The supply voltage positive portion attached with capacitor negative portion, and supply voltage negative point negative portion attached with resistor and diode common point in here. When we supply 500 hertz from signal generator, we see a waveform just like that. Waveform will be like that. From it's like that. When in channel one, we add channel one in the wave, in the breadboard. You add channel one in the breadboard. When and for channel two and for the output, in it is the input and the output. When we add channel in the capacitor and the diode common point, we see waveform like that. In the yellow point indicates the indicates the input point, and the blue point indicates the output point. From the graph, we can see that the output voltage graph is doubled from the input voltage graph. Lampard circuit increase if increase the supply input. If we supply 5 volt in the input, the Lampard circuit output will be 10 volt, double. First of all, in the first slide, I show that the clamp it is a negative clamped circuit, so the output voltage will be negative in double. If the diode is if the diode, let me indicate in that from the is like that, that it will be a positive clamped circuit. The output will be the output show output. Output will be in double, just like that. In complete, it's like that. So I think I. So that's all. Thank you, everyone. Assalamualaikum.